All right, guys, today we're tuning this Pontiac Solstice. It is a RP Motorsports turbo setup on the car. Really low boost, like 5 pounds, nothing too crazy. Not sure what to expect out of her power numbers, but we're gonna jump into it and see what we can make. Alright guys, here's this Pontiac Solstice. Like I said, it's got an RP Motorsports turbocharger kit on it. This is the only, I've never tuned one of these Ecotec engines before, so I'm going to have to learn a little bit about it. Obviously I'm familiar with the GM ECU stuff. Yeah, neat little car. I always like these, the Saturn Skies. They're kind of cool. They look like a good time, like a GM's version of the Miata, I guess. Plus with that engine in there, those things would make some power. This thing, the goal with this really isn't to make a horsepower number. We're more just looking for just good drivability. It only makes 5 pounds or so. Nothing serious, just obviously pump gas thing. So yeah, I'm gonna dive into this, see if we can sort out some of the drivability issues and what kind of power we can make with it. Alright guys, real quick before I show you what this thing made, I wanted to show you the timing map that was in this previously. So this is the timing map that was in it. I can't even put into words how frustrated it is to see that somebody made a timing map like this and sent it out with a job. I have no idea what they were thinking. I don't know what happened here. I don't know. Anyway, it's horrible. Here's what's in it now. That's what it did look like, something like that. And yeah, that's what was in it before. Pretty bad deal. No wonder the thing didn't run well, right? Also, the other thing I wanted to show you quick was the VE map that was in it. Check this guy out. It's a real gem. So that was the VE map that was in the car. I honestly don't know how it ran and drove as good as it did. So, but anyway, yeah, check it out. That's I just wanted to show you guys this quick before I started to do what we made with it. So yeah, here we go.
Okay, we made 228 foot-pounds of torque, 197 horsepower,
which all in all isn't too bad. It's 5 pounds of boost on the spike right at the hit, and then it pretty much falls the rest of the RPM range all the way down to like 2 pounds, 2.5 pounds up top, 122 kPa up top. So yeah, it'd be nice to fix that. I'd put a ball and spring style controller in it. I think that would sort that out. As you saw from the screen record there of the VE maps and the timing maps that were in this thing, it really needed some tuning help. When it got here, you would, if you put it in the wrong part of the timing map, it was almost acted like it had an anti-lag situation going on. And it basically did. Their response in the timing map, that would be like, it would be 10, 13 degrees at one cell, and the cell right next to it would be -3. I don't know what the deal was with that. Yeah, the tune was pretty rough shape. So it's all good, running good now. So it'd be nice to turn the boost up in this thing, but that isn't the goal here. It was just to pep the car up a little bit so it's a little more fun to drive. And so that's it. We're gonna send it on its way. And if they wanna make more later, we can do that.